Welcome. See the sum if 2 plus x plus 3x square whole to the power 6 equals to a0 plus a1x. In this way it will be up to a2x x to the power 12. Then the value of a5. Obviously it is a12 is the coefficient of x to the power 12. So a5 will be the coefficient of x to the power 5. So we have to find the coefficient of x to the power 5. How we can proceed? We can write this one as x plus 2 plus 3x square whole to the power 6. This one can be expanded in this time. That is x plus 2 whole to the power 6 plus 6c1, that is 6 into x plus 2 whole to the power 5 into 3x square plus 6c2, that is 6 into 5 by 2 into x plus 2 whole to the power 4 into 3x square whole square. If we are expanding further, next term it will come 3x square whole cube, that will be x to the power 6 by what we require a5, that is the coefficient of x to the power 5 we require. So we need not require to do it further. Further there will be no term which can contain x to the power 5, because minimum power will be x to the power 6. So if we are expanding this one, here we require only x to the power 5. So x to the power 5 in this expression, it will be there in the second term, that is 6c1 x to the power 5 into 2. This will be the second term in this. So in this second term, what is the coefficient? 6 into 2, that is coefficient is 12. Now here, if we are expanding this one, from here only, where I show only the required expansion, from here we can see this is 18x square into x plus 2 whole to the power 5. But we require into x cube, that will give us x to the power 5. So x cube will be there in third term, that is into 5. Third term means 5c3. X cube will be there in now third term will be t to 5c2 x to the power 3 and into 2 to the power 5 minus 2, that is 2 to the power 3. X to the power 3, that is x to the power, here if we are doing, it will be 5c2, x to the power 5 minus 2 will be 3, and 2 to the power 5c2, so it will be 2 to the power 2 in this way. So here the coefficient is coming 18 into 5c2, that is 5 into 4 by 2 into 4, 2 to the 4, 4 into 18, 72, 72 2 into 10, 720. This is the expansion. Now, we have to find in this one. This can be written as 15. This is coming 15. 3 is 9. Then 15 into 9 is 135 x to the power 4 from these two. So from here only x is required for getting x to the power 5. X will be there in the fourth term, that is 4c3 into x into 2 to the power 3. Actually it will be 4 minus 3. 4 minus 3 means 1 into 2 to the power 3. Here it will be there. So the term is coming 135 into 4c3 means 4 into 8. So 135 into 4 into 8. 135 into 2 is 270. 270 into 2 is 540. 540, that is 135 into 4 is 540 into 8. 800, 8 4 are 32, carry 3, 8 5 are 43. So if we are adding, it is 2, 5, 5052. So this will be the coefficient of x to the power 5. That is a5 is. Now see this up. If x equals to 1 plus 1 by 4, etc., y equals to this one, z equals to this one, then the value of x, y by z. That means we have to find x, y and z separately, then only we can find this value. See here carefully. This is x, y and z. All are infinite series. Infinite GP. These are infinite GP. And infinite GP sum equals to a by 1 minus r, where r is the common ratio. This formula you have to remember for finding the sum of an infinite GP series. So x equals to, here a is 1, that is the first term, by 1 minus r is second term by first term, that is 1 by 4. So it is coming 1 by 3 by 4 equals to 4 by 3. Now y equals to, in the same style, first term is 2 by 1 minus, here see it is minus 2 by 4 by 2, minus 2 by 4 by 2, so it will be minus 1 by 4, that is equals to 2 by 1 plus 1 by 4, this is equals to 2 by 5 by 4, this is equals to 8 by 5. Similarly, z equals to, first term is 3 by 1 minus, here common ratio is 3 by 4 square by 3, that is 1 by 4 square, 4 square is 16, so this is equals to 3 by 15 by 16 equals to 48 by 15. We are cancelling 16 by 5. So we got x, y and z. Now what we have to find the value of x, y by z. X is 4 by 3 into y is 8 by 5 by z is 16 by 5. this is equals to 4 by 3 into 8 by 5 into 5 by 16. 5, 5, 8, 2, 2. So equals to 2 by 3. This is your answer of this question.